Hey, what's going on, everyone? So I unlocked SP Sherry when it was available and I just didn't have time to make a build guide of her, and now I finally do, and I think it's really important that you know how to use her properly and how to equip her properly. She is a very, very strong unit. So if you already unlocked her, well, you need like 6 stars. She is so good at 6 stars, and let me explain what she does. So her original She is really strong before, like attack and stuff, but her SP form takes a little bit more damage compared to the old one. The old one has a little bit more damage reduction, but it doesn't really matter. So there's two new skills here, which is these two. So SP Share is a holy class, and she has 4 range movement. However, her new passive here, this one cost passive, is actually so broken. So this one cost, unit mobility plus 2. So when you equip this passive, you basically has a enhanced apex boots that can, well, kind of. Okay, you just get like a crazy boots, allow you to move plus 2. And when formed of mixed forces, after taking action, restore 30% of unit HP. So this, they made this one so that you can replace this or this. You lose a little bit damage and attack right here, but they gave you a better version of health regeneration. Well, these are pretty trash. Okay, so mixed force means holy class as long as the troops are not holy class, which you will be able to do that because there are no holy troops available for her to use. So, in any situation, you are using holy class. Not holy class, sorry, mixed forces. Okay, so this is really good. Makes her move 6 raw without any like mobility buff whatsoever. So 6 movement, and then we're going to take a look at the new talent here. When unit moves, all passable terrains is considered as planes, which means okay, so Unicorn does that already. Unit movement type is changed to Terrain Master, which means you can go through like mountains, forests without any restrictions. So her talent does the same thing here, consider as plane. So it doesn't matter what troop you use, any troops you use, you will have no terrain restriction, which is really good. So she basically is no different than a flyer, no different than her previous flying class, but it's plus 1 movement. When forced into battle, damage taken is decreased by 20%. I'm pretty sure before is 25%, so you're losing 5%, but it's not a big deal. When initiating battle, attack increases by 25%. After battle, before you need to kill in order to act again, but this right now, after battle, if there is only one enemy or less within 2 blocks, can act again 1 additional time. So this is not hard to trigger. Okay, the reason why is because of this new skill here, Holy Thunder. Attacks a single enemy dealing 1.4 times damage, afflicts a displacement effect which pushes target back 2 blocks. So this helps you fulfill this requirement much easier. Okay, after battle, if there's only one enemy or less, so if you knock them back, you can kind of have a little bit more control. Okay, so that is SP Sherry when it comes to these and this. And her 3C, if you don't know, deals 1.6 times damage to a single enemy after battle. 100% of the damage that will be restored your HP, which usually will fully restore. And when you successfully eliminate a target, its cooldown is reduced by 4 turns, otherwise the enemy will be stunned. So this is a very safe skill. Either you stun them or you kill them, but either or, you will have your HP fully restored unless you get counter killed. And it's really good because you can go in, use this skill, kill someone, or if you fail to kill, that person is stunned and you fully restore HP. Now if you did trigger ACK again, now you can go in and use your other skill to kill. And soldier wise, she now has assassin here, which can help you. If you are going to use her as an assassin, using a shadow right here, now you have a chance to just ignore guard and kill the enemy directly using this because of her very high attack. Okay, so now we're gonna talk about her. Okay, shut up. Oh my god. I just clicked the wrong button and she keeps talking. Okay, so we're gonna talk about her weapon. Renarok, I think, is the best because you can just break a lot of these techs. Like, example, if opponent has last rites, you can break it and easily kill your opponent. You can have Shrine Maiden and etc. As long as they're not 100%, most of the tech, they don't have that high damage reduction. So Renarok is probably my first to go gear. If not, there are a lot of options, such as you can use even these swords now. Depends how you want to use her. Definitely don't use anything that gives you int. Use anything that gives you attack. So I would say Renarok goes first. Secondly, I think... excuse me, this one is also a very good weapon. If you don't have that, I think this is also very good. So these three I would probably recommend first. And if you don't have any of that, I think Seal Guardian and stuff are pretty safe, or even... honestly, any weapon works, but I think these three are probably the best. So if you were to use Renarok, you probably don't need Twilight. But if you're using this, you probably want to use Twilight, but you don't have to. But this here, if you use Twilight, this part will never trigger because your enemy needs to be at 100% HP. So it depends what you have. Play around and then try to find your best. But Renarok, by far, if a character can use Renarok, that usually is his or her best gear. Okay, so now when it comes to armor, there's two options. Literally. So Last Rite or her exclusive. Okay, so I like Last Rite more because of her damage reduction. And because of Last Rite, that's 60% right off the bat. This is harder to, like, it's harder for you to get killed. And then she has all these different troops like angels. If you have to fight against magic. This one here, you don't die when initiating battle only. So when you're attacking. But when you're attacking, her talent most likely will allow you to trigger the act again. Then it's kind of pointless. You probably won't die. Like, get counter kill. I don't think anyone is strong enough to counter kill. So if you use Last Rite, it's the same effect. It's really hard for you to... explode, like kill yourself. So I would say I would go for Last Rite over the other one. And then if you are using Last Rite, I suggest Glory of the World. It's because before being forced into battle, heals 10% of HP if the unit is formed of mixed forces. And like I said, if you're using SPL Sherry, it will be mixed force, which this fits her perfectly. And if you have Last Rite, the chance of you getting that HP back and have the Last Rite effect at 100%, this is really good. But if you don't have a Last Rite, you're using a different armor, then I say probably use Fury of Tear, because Fury of Tear will allow you to deal more damage with your skills. And then if you don't have these two, then honestly, whichever armor will work. Helmet will work. I think you can probably go for Kane's Crown, Tanya, whatever. Okay, so now I would say Judge Talisman might be one of the best, but honestly, any accessory that gives you that 8% is great. But I'll talk about why I think Judge is the best. I think Judge is the best is because there are just so many new powerful holy units, and it just helps you kill faster, easier. When it comes to other accessory, I think they're as good. But depends on what the meta is. If you don't want to use any of this, I think Overlord Badge is good. This one is also good. Wing Shin Guard gives you more defense when you get hit. And again, Twilight, if you don't have Renarok and you want to break those 100% damage reduction, 100% health damage reduction technology, then Twilight will work. That's pretty much it. Pretty straightforward, and yeah, you just want her to be alone when you're attacking to trigger. You can just go in and kill two by yourself. Even Lone Star is not a bad option. I'm just gonna talk about right here. I think Lone Star is also very good. where no friendly units are within two blocks. I think this also fits her perfectly. For yeah, now if we talk about enchant, I think Breeze is the best. If you have six movement plus Breeze, I think yeah, that's pretty dangerous. But if you don't want to use that, you can use Rough Sea, you can go Full Moon, because she most likely will have, when you're the one initiating, you will have your HP beyond 80% most of the time. And if you want more crit, Blazing Sun, Meteor will work. And that's pretty much it. And the most often used soldier would probably be Unicorn. Depends on what other side has. Griffin Knight and then Earth Elf Knight. These three will be the most common. And this is also very strong if you're fighting against magic dealers. And then let me see, last but not least, it would be here. You probably want to go, I would go skill. I think skill is pretty important if you get that crit. And then here, defense, attack. That's fine. I think magic defense is not very relevant because all the magic damage dealers, they just hit so hard. Even if you have high enough magic damage, it doesn't help. But if you have Angel, it's going to help regardless, even if your character has low magic defense, because the Angel is going to take it for you. So I think maybe focus more on the defense side rather than the magic defense side and HP and stuff. Mine is not built. I just slap on gears, and it's just to try her out to make sure I have the information correct before I make this video. And yeah. Alright guys, thank you for watching. I hope this video helped you understand this character better. And if you didn't unlock her, or if you don't have Sherry, I think it's a very good time to build her. I think she's great in PvE and PvP, and she's in three fashion. Okay guys, bye bye.